You don't want to talk about how the banks are starting that down, Bitcoin, crypto right now?
No, I wanted that to be my Saturday class.
Hey guys, good morning. So it is Wednesday. It's snowing outside, but I live in New York. That's the thing, I've been wanting to move out of New York for years, like even before Noah was born. Every time I think about moving, because I was going to move this year, something just brings me back. And of course, by me being hired by one of the top healthcare providers in New York City, or New York State rather, I don't want to leave now, because I don't want to burn any bridges. And you know, hopefully this will be home for me, especially because it's a reputable, prestigious provider to work for. So today I have a simulation for orientation, and I'm not sure exactly what we're doing, but I'm hoping that it just goes by fast, because I don't want to be here all day. I'm waiting in my car right now for a text message or email saying that it's okay for me to come in. Of course, I have to fill out this COVID screening tool. I don't even know how to access it. I don't even have my universal ID. Today's gonna be a long day. I already feel it, because we go from this facility to the next with different buildings for different purposes. So yeah, I'm just hoping that I get called soon, because this is
cool.
Hi, good morning.
Hi, good morning. What
can I have you? Can I get a grande vanilla sweet cream cold brew with the cold foam? And can I get nutmeg and cinnamon on top of that?
Nutmeg and that?
Yes, please. And the cinnamon as well.
Alrighty, anything else?
Yes. Can I get, oh my god, I forgot the daggone thing. A croissant. Butter croissant toasted.
You want that warmed up?
Yes, please. So guys, I'm at Starbucks in the line in the drive-thru, and I'm already late for work. Not that it's an excuse to be late for work, because the roads are pretty clear, but your girl is gonna have a long day. I have a whole bunch of patients and I need some cafe, so it is what it is. I'm not gonna make this a habit, of course, but I was already over here and the line wasn't bad. Considering the line is always bad in this drive-thru, I was like, you know what, let me just go, because there was nobody here. Well, there was two cars out in front of me, but yeah. So I'll see y'all when I get to work. Oh my gosh, this person keeps opening their door because they have ice all over their door. It's so bad. It's so cold out here. All right. You know they want me but the sweet, sweet talking. Pretty eyes, pretty lips. All right, guys, so I'm on break right now. I'm taking my lunch, but it's been a slow day, actually. Not being patient. Normally is, but that's okay. So I'm here in the office. This is where we keep the Botox. This is for the residents. I have my own little clinic stash here, and then I also have the surgical supplies here, and this is my main desk. Yeah, I'm gonna eat this food because my break is almost up. I have to get back to work. So I'll see you when I get home. So I'm about to lose my light. I'm gonna talk to you guys really quickly. So last month I went through my employee health screening. This is when they do your physical, your titers, whatever services that you need in order to get clearance, to get your job, and go for orientation, of course. So my hospital happens to be the first in New York State to receive the vaccine. And on this particular day, they asked me if I wanted to get the vaccine. And I was like, I don't know if I wanna be vaccinated right now. I was curious to know if I had antibodies. So she was like, oh, I'll do the antibody test. So I just got my results, guys, and I scored a measurement of 70, which is pretty high, and it says that on a paper. Now, I'm not surprised by it. I mean, I worked frontline, I worked in the OR, I was around patients that tested positive, also went to Mexico, but I don't think I contracted anything going to Mexico, who knows. But I tested negative in all my tests. When I worked frontline, I was getting tested weekly. When I was working in an OR, I was tested regularly, and before I went to Mexico and when I came back, I tested negative. So I don't know, but the thing that has me worried is the fact that I have Noah, and I'm just like, could he have had it? You know, could he have contracted it from somebody at school? I don't know, this thing is just so weird. And I'm thinking to myself, like, I must be one of those asymptomatic people, because I had no symptoms or anything that had me question or think twice about it. And that's also why I went away. Not a total excuse to go away, but I wanted to get away. And bro, And I just had this sense of guilt at the same time, but I'm just thankful that I'm okay and I haven't been sick. Hopefully I don't ever get sick. Part of me feels kind of dumb for not taking advantage of the vaccine, but I did get an email today saying I could still schedule my appointment. But then I have my coworkers who are like, well, you have the antibodies, like it makes no sense for you to get the vaccine. But I'm like, even though I have the antibodies, that does not protect me 100% against this virus. Like, this virus is kind of doing its own thing, it's replicating, and I don't know, I just don't want to spread it. Like, I could have it right now. I don't know, I think I should go for it. I don't know, you guys let me know what you think. I know there's a vaccine coming in April, supposedly it's coming from the UK. They're saying that it's more effective because it's more lively. Then we have the Johnson & Johnson coming, so I don't even know. He's gonna blow my phone up. So guys, I wanted to show you all what I got from Bath & Body Works. They didn't really have a sale, but for the candles, the one wick candles, they were 2 for $20. So I have the strawberry pound cake, which smells pretty good. Champagne toast, I always wanted this one. And it smells really good on a cold sniff. These both are good. I think I'm gonna give one to my sister. Then I also have the hand soap here, really, really cute. And then hand spray, which I want to keep at work at my desk. And then I also got the champagne toast in 3-wick, and it smells so good, so, so good. I just got to work. I'm about to settle in, sign in. I'm gonna decorate this. I just started, but it's not done. You know they told me you will fall too easily, but guess I like the quick fix. It's just not that I don't listen, it's just the way you're coming so close to me. It's just not that I don't feel the tension, it's just the way I want you to come closer. Morning, guys. Well, good afternoon. Did you guys see the time? Can y'all see it? I don't know if y'all can see it, but it is in the afternoon. So I wanted to talk to you guys about my responsibilities, how the job has been going. You guys know that I started a new job. I actually got hired by Magnet Hospital, which I'm gonna talk to you guys about in a little bit, because I know that took some people off guard, like an LPN in the Magnet Hospital. I'm gonna give y'all the tea in a little bit. But yeah, I got hired as a clinical lead. I work specifically in ambulatory, let's stress that, outpatient. And I work for a dermatology / pathology office. So I work for a clinic / lab / hospital. We're all on the same campus. This is a clinic for the most part. It's split up from the derm side and then the surgical side, because we have a mold surgical side with the lab, and then we have the lab on my side, clinic, whatever you want to call it. I'm still getting acclimated, by the way, so I'm going to tell you guys what I know so far, what I've been doing. Now, I showed you guys the eczema machine, which is a UVB machine that's used to target mild to moderate psoriasis, vitiligo. I have patients that come in with all different types of dermatitis, and I know some of you guys were asking me if I got the clear to use this machine. I went through clinical training for it. I also was approved from the top MD that is a clinical researcher for this hospital, so I'm in good hands. I don't feel uncomfortable. I did my research, and this is not the first time that I've used a laser machine. Now, you definitely want to be careful when you're using these machines. You want to make sure that the person is trained, because you don't want to burn a patient, but you have to be mindful that you are treating that specific area, not the surrounding skin, but you can burn any skin that has not been exposed to it before. But as things go, I'll probably talk about this further. I don't want to drag this out. And also, when I'm treating these patients, I'm not just doing it willingly. I have to have consent. I have to make sure that everything is approved by either the resident or the attending doctor. So yeah, it's a whole process. And speaking about the residents, I work alongside my residents in my department as well. I do consultations, I do post-op follow-up. I also call patients when it comes to their lab results, their benign biopsies. I do a number of things. I could be here all day talking about that, but I also work with rheumatology specifically. I work in scheduling these appointments for patients that are getting infusion treatment. These are patients with all different types of autoimmune disorders. So on my end, I just make sure that the orders are approved, pre-medications are filled, everything is set to go. It's a lot of administrative tasks, and this is completely different from what I've done before. I mean, I'm still dealing with patients, but I'm not as hands-on as of yet. Also, I will be working on the OR side, the surgical side. On my side, we do perform biopsies, but on the other side, I'll be doing a little bit more alongside those doctors. But yeah, it's pretty interesting. I don't know if I'm forgetting anything. Another thing is, I know you guys were interested in this, but I manage the Botox of the office, even though I don't specifically administer Botox to these patients. But I showed you guys that I pretty much handle the back end of that. So yeah, they call me the Botox girl because they have to come to me in order to get their Botox. But yeah, I'll probably show you guys that part of everything as well, because we do have a cosmetic side. But yeah, I feel like I kind of covered the basics of what I've been doing so far. Of course, you guys can follow me and I will keep you all abreast as to what I do. And that's the thing, my responsibilities will expand. Speaking of this, because I said I'm gonna get back to this. So considering I got hired by a magnet hospital, I feel like this is really due to COVID. I feel like they're becoming more lenient, because you know, with the magnet hospitals, they are hiring the top tier, the creme de la creme, making sure that you have your BSN. And that's also what was interesting about my orientation. I was literally the only LPN. So I was in a sea of people that have come from all different types of life, different departments, ER, ICU, you name it, okay? And my simulations were pretty thorough. Even though it's not what I'm doing, I'm not working inpatient, they want to make sure that you are competent and able to perform as a nurse. So it definitely tested my clinical background, my bedside skills, my critical thinking, making sure, hey, I know my labs and everything. On another note, I have some sneakers that I just got in the mail. Y'all gonna see. Some sneakers for work. So these are the NMDs from Adidas. That's Noah in the background, by the way. He is so unhappy with me right now. I'm about to feed him some lunch. I wanted the all black, but it is what it is. It's breathable material. I feel like they last for a long time, but mine got messed up because I was doing the most. I was cleaning in the OR. So guys, I just finished cleaning up the kitchen just a little bit. I am working in the kitchen, so I have stuff out, but I figured I would make myself some teriyaki chicken. I have some chicken breast I'm gonna season up. I also have some veggies that I might as well just use for the stir fry. Yeah, the oven's ready, so I'm gonna get started on that. But I wanted to show you guys, look at these cookies that I got from Target. They're so good. This is the brand. I don't know if they'll still have them after Valentine's Day weekend, which is this weekend, but they're really good. Me and my sister pretty much picked at it. There was a whole bunch of cookies in here. Doesn't hurt to treat yourself. So I just put the chicken in the oven. I chopped up some broccoli, some red peppers, yellow peppers, some onion. I have some snap peas in here, some cucumber. I don't have mushroom, but it's okay. I had mushroom last week. It is what it is. But I think I put pretty much everything that I could think of to make this stir fry. I'm getting creative. I'm gonna clean this up right now. So guys, this is the finished product. I have here my chicken breast, and I made some teriyaki sauce on the side. I have my stir fry. I put a little bit of everything, cucumbers. I also put ginger in there, by the way. I have my peppers, onions, broccoli, snap peas. I think that's pretty much everything. And then I also picked up this cheap sangria from the grocery store. I don't even know how much it was, honestly, but I'm assuming that it was cheap. So I got this in rosé. I'm hoping that it tastes good. It's my first time trying it. I've seen it, but I've never tried it. And there's my little glass that I got from the restaurant out east when I went with my girlfriend. This was like 2 years ago. So yeah, I'm about to have my dinner, but I'm gonna chop up Noah's as well because I'm not gonna eat alone, obviously.
Noah, you ready to read? You wanna read, Pops? Yeah, you gotta open it. You gotta open it. Turn the page, please. Noah, turn the page. Noah, turn the page, please. Turn the page, please. Gonna read? Alright. Berenstain Bears, Funny Valentine. It may be chilly outside when Valentine's Day comes, but little bears warm up and send cards to their chums. Returning, and Amy was jumping. Uh-oh, said Lizzie. There's a boy coming over from the boy side of the playground, and guess who it is? You're not even looking. You're too busy looking at Big Bird. Ready. Hey guys, so I'm getting ready for bed. Noah's over here doing the most. He did not want to read the book. I don't know why, because it was a really cute book, but I guess that wasn't his cup of tea. He's so into Sesame Street. But anyways, tomorrow is Valentine's Day. What are you guys doing for Valentine's Day? Let me know. I don't really have anything planned, surprisingly. Hopefully next year it'll be different. I'm gonna sit up. I actually feel like I've been running on E, literally E for everyone except myself. And I know that's partially the reason why I've been feeling so out of it. Noah is too funny. Only my child. What are you doing? What are you trying to see? You trying to see the TV? He doesn't realize that it's bedtime and I'm trying to put him to sleep. Are you pushing me? And now you're pulling me. What are you doing? And that's another thing too. It's like, I just wish that I could have some time to myself. Like, I love my son. There's nothing wrong with me having, you know, a moment to myself though, because mommy is just always on the go and yeah. All of that, and you gotta pull my hair. But yeah, I've just been doing a lot, and I'm actually in the process of packing my things. I will be moving next month, towards the end of next month, so this will be another new venture for me, which I definitely need. I need to get out of this environment, and I definitely need space because I can't be going through this and feeling like I'm just, you know, in a box, because I literally am in a box right now. Further, if you guys are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. I know I've been MIA, and that's another thing. I actually broke my camera. You guys follow me on Instagram. I told you guys that my Canon G37 broke, or G7X, whatever. Yeah, G7X broke. So I ended up having to go get myself another one. I'll probably get the other one fixed, but yeah, that's why I was MIA originally. And of course, with the job and everything, it's just been a lot. So, but I am back, and I guess I will see you guys on Wednesday. Say night night. Say night, because it's night night time. Really? All right guys, I'll see you in the next one.